you very much, Chris, and thank you all for coming. It's a real pleasure to be here today. My program is framed by two of J.S. Bach's grandest preludes and fugues. The prelude of the opening piece is clearly influenced by Italian concerto grosso style. We hear tutti sections alternating with solo sections. However, Bach imbues this light, accessible genre with what might be termed German seriousness. The fugue is, if anything, even more somber. Halfway through, we hear the entry of a second theme, and the two themes are then combined in a dazzling finale. The three movements by Raison and the movement by de Grigny, which follow, offer something of a contrast. They are more lyrical, and they show off the soloistic colors of the organ. There's a real vocal quality to this music. In a sense, it anticipates music like the songs of songs without words by 19th century composers such as Mendelssohn. And then to finish with the Prelude and Fugue in E flat by Bach. This piece was written at a time when Bach was being criticized for being too old-fashioned. And you can hear that he's trying to counter that accusation. The prelude is written in a very up-to-date French, in the style of a French overture, which was a very fashionable style at the time. And then in the fugue, it's in three sections. He starts off with a very old-fashioned style, a kind of imitation of the 16th century music of Palestrina and so on. And he gradually moves further up to date, and it ends up with a real jig-like section to finish. Thank you again for coming, and I hope you enjoy the programme.